We got her with a shoulder workout today, so we're going to begin by going over what she did for her shoulders. Now, you were telling me that you actually had some trouble with the shoulders for a while. Tell me about that.
Yeah, actually, last year, I didn't realize it until this year I started working out with shoulders, but I couldn't really do any presses at all whatsoever for an entire year. I had, you know, a small twinge in one of my shoulders that really limited me from doing any heavy pressing. So I really just kept myself to any kind of isolation moves, like side laterals, just one plane movements.
What do you credit with getting you past that?
You know, just nurturing the area, giving it rest. Like I said, I took a whole year of rest from something that really irritated it. I did massage therapy and chiropractic and just, like I said, just gave it rest and nurture.
And you told me you're a big believer in the massage therapy because you actually do that as well yourself.
I do. I've been doing that for a little over 10 years. So yes, I strongly believe in that and a lot of stretching.
Okay, so let's talk about the actual workout. We started with some presses, and now who was that you had working out with you?
That was my fiance, Antoine Ware.
So how important is it to you to have someone working out with you? I noticed he did stand behind you. He was definitely there.
Very important, especially when you're really trying to push the limit and put on some size and grow a little bit. You need a spot because otherwise you can't push yourself to failure. You can injure yourself.
Let's compare this kind of workout that you're doing right now to maybe your off-season workouts. What are we seeing you do different right now? Or do you work out the same all the time?
It's the same. It hasn't changed.
And you start with presses. Do you always start with presses?
Not always, but this year I really tried to push up the weight on that, necessarily to put on some size there. So this year I have always started.
So have we definitely seen some size added to your shoulders?
Yeah, I think we'll see some noticeable changes. I think it's one, at least 2 inches difference since last year.
Okay. And then we went into, you grabbed the easy curl bar and you did some upright rows. So.
Yeah, just increment, you know, 12 to 10, 8, just 8 basic plain sets of upright rows. And I used a wider grip rather than a narrow grip towards more of the medial and rear delts.
Do you have the same, do you do pretty much the same exercises every time? Like when you're working the front shoulders, do you do the same thing every time or do we see you incorporate?
I have
things?
Stayed to the same basic movements. However, sometimes I'll change, instead of upright rows, I'll do some front raises for that area. But basically I've stayed with a lot of the same movements and it's really helped get back to the basics.
And then we moved into something that you said you call your heavy light sets. Tell us about those.
I call them heavy light sets because I really think the quality of contraction is most important on developing a muscle group. And going into a heavy set, you can do as many as you can heavy with good form. And I like to lighten the weight to go into a few more extra reps of perfect form.
And you said that you always keep the light weight the same.
Yeah.
So you're,
you know,
you're
I go up on the heavy weight.
The heavy and then come back to the light every time.
Okay. It's just about what you can do, I think.
And then you showed us two different things for rear shoulders. We went over to the cables, and you did too. You had two different positions that you incorporated.
Yeah, I did a single bent over raise, and then went right into an external rotation.
Okay, and then you also showed us on the pec deck, you did reverse. Now, if we weren't here, would you do both of those, or?
I just did a burnout set on that. So yeah, I mean, I changed that up. The rear delts, there's so many different movements you can do. High cable, you know, pull downs. And I mean, there's a lot of different things. So yeah, I would have done all of it, but it was just one drop set at the end.
And you're very strict with your form on all your exercises.
Yes, it's very important to me.
And I know people are wanting to know about your diet this time of year. Tell us how your diet's going.
You know what, honestly, and I think I mentioned this last year in another video I did, but my diet doesn't change much. I have one cheat day a week.
So you have a whole cheat day?
I have a whole cheat day on Sunday, and it will be like that all the way up until the show.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Even
the Sunday before the show.
Now, how far out there do you go on your cheat day? Like some people lose control on a cheat day. Like
it's controlled, but I eat all day. I mean, I have 6 cheat meals.
If you want some donuts that morning, you'll have donuts, or?
Yeah, I mean, my coach, we try to keep it consistent. So, you know, he gives me leeway in the beginning part of the training. He's like, just go have your cheat day. And then he's like, okay, what have you been eating? I'm like, well, I've had, you know, I can have a clean breakfast generally, and then I'll have bagel, and then I'll have pizza, and then I'll have some, you know, South Beach bars and a scoop of protein. You know, I keep the protein in along with every meal.
And speaking of the protein, when we first got here, you were mixing up a little pre-workout drink, and you talked about having the shakes and the. Some people cut the shakes out in their contest prep. You're keeping them in the whole time?
Yeah, I've never had to really cut them out. I mean, only in my early years of training did we cut out the shakes a week or two before, but looking at my conditioning and you know, my leanness, he's pretty much allowed me to keep it in. It's just depending on how I look. You know, it goes off of how I'm progressing, and I usually progress pretty quickly in my training, and I get ready pretty quickly.
Do you want to say how lean you are now, or?
I mean, that's fine. I mean, my numbers are 1.1, but we know that human error, that's not always perfectly accurate, you know.
Right.
So,
when we were talking about when I got here, that some people think the pros don't actually use the shakes and the supplements, but I mean, you did.
Oh, I do. I use the pre-workout drink, yes, and I have a post-workout drink, absolutely. That saves me during the day.
And you mentioned your coach several times. Now, you went pro in 2007 at Nationals as a middleweight. He was with you then, but he was with you long before then, too.
He's been with me since the beginning, since I ever started competing. I mean, he's the reason that I've done so well. If it weren't for him, I wouldn't have known what to do. You know, I always knew how to work out and wanted to do bodybuilding, but until I met Johnny West, you know, that was when I realized, okay, he has the expertise that can take me where I want to go, and he has.
And you were the first person that did turn pro for him.
Yes.
So how did y'all meet?
I do personal training, and I came to his gym, Houston Gym, which is where we're at today. And he's the owner of the gym, and his reputation preceded him. Everybody's like, oh, Johnny knows what he's doing. You should go talk to Johnny. You know, we met, and, you know, the next year I competed and went from there.
Going back even farther than that, you said you were a teenager when you started lifting weights the first time. What got you, like, as a teenager? Yeah, I was a chubby girl. I didn't know people were lifting weights. What got you into this? How did you know?
Yeah, I was a competitive gymnast as a young girl. Like, about 8 years old is when I started doing gymnastics. I was naturally very gifted and competed for many years until I was 13 and I quit. When I was 13, I wanted to somehow keep the conditioning going because I naturally developed muscles as a little girl. And at 13, I went into the weight room at the high school and started lifting weights there.
Yeah, this is your first Arnold coming up. Tell me, how excited were you when you got the letter and you knew you were accepted?
I was honored. You know, it's very exciting to be invited to such an event.
Yeah, it's an amazing achievement because not everybody gets to do that.
It's complete acknowledgement of who you are and what you are trying to do. So
will you be nervous? Does it overwhelm you, or is it you're still going to treat it the same as the other competitions you've done before?
I'm not overwhelmed, you know, because I have competed in these big shows. It's just another experience that I look forward to.
Yeah.
That I really want to do my best, better than my best has been.
Okay. Because you have been to the Olympia twice, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, I've competed in the Olympia twice, and I've been to the Arnold a number of times. You know, 3 or 4 times. So I've kind of been there, I've seen it, I kind of know what to expect on the spectator part of it. So now I'm, you know, looking forward to experiencing the competitor side.
Yeah, and I was telling you that my first knowing of you was you caught my eye because your suit. Let's talk about your suits a little bit. Who is it that makes your suits for
Jody
you?
Bruce. Yes.
I love the little black suit, had the little
tuxedo.
Yeah,
my first
trimming.
Olympia.
Yeah,
it was like a little tuxedo suit. That was the cutest.
So she's still
she's
your
very talented.
Suit maker.
Still does all my suits, and she's wonderful.
Let's touch on another semi-controversial subject. The New York Pro. Mm-hmm. You've been in it before.
I have.
And there's not going to be a female bodybuilder New York Pro this year. How do you feel about that?
How do you think I feel about that? it's the same thing in Houston.
I think it's
because the
board.
Houston Pro Show, since we've ever had a Houston Pro Show, has never had women. We have never had women bodybuilders here.
Right.
Oh, yeah, I'm in Houston, so absolutely, it's in my face.
Right.
You know? But I also understand that there is a business aspect to it, so I would really like to learn more about the resources and where these monies are coming from and how it's being allotted. Because I recently found out that, on a controversial issue, that there will be a Best Posing Award for the men at the Arnold. $10,000 for the best poser.
But not.
So, but nothing for the women.
And even that's controversial, too, though.
But if there's extra money like that to throw around, why not be fair and give everyone? I just would like to learn more about.
Of course, why not bring 202 into it? Because we're also at the Arnold.
And they're so mistreated as well. They are treated like stepchildren. I mean, they are. So.
Okay. What about the women's physique division coming along? Would you ever consider giving that a try? You would have to, you know, if they go by what
no,
they say
I've
the looks
about that.
Be.
I've thought about that, and no, I wouldn't. And I know that a lot of people can see me doing that because I'm not that far from that look.
Right.
However, this is my view on this. I'm excited about the class. Bring it on. Because you know what it does? It involves more women. It involves more athletes. It involves more regular people wanting to compete. It gives everybody a place to compete. Now, from there, people are, oh, bodybuilding is going to be gone. No. You know why? I will totally lay my hands on this. It's because every athlete wants to be a better athlete, always and forever. So there always will need be a need for a greater class. How is that going to go anywhere?
About that.
Any athlete wants to be.
We were talking about that on the way up. As I was driving in, I said, I see the same thing happening with women's physique because whoever wins, they're going to strive to be better.
To be better. That's the nature of.
Cross over into female bodybuilding.
Absolutely. I have no fear we're not going anywhere. None at all. I never have.
Okay, is there anybody else that you would like to give a shout out?
Well, definitely Johnny West in here at Houston Gym. And with Carolyn Bryant, Jody Bruce.
We've got all the people on the
list.
Oh, my website. You know, I've just revamped my whole website. And my new member section should be opening within a week, so please visit TinaChandler.com.
www.TinaChandler.com.
Yes.
We will definitely put that when we put the video out there. We'll put a link to that in it.
I will be at the expo most likely Sunday afternoon. Yeah.
Okay.
I'll be busy with photo shoots the rest of the weekend.
Okay. And you definitely like it when people come introduce. I know sometimes people are intimidated and scared to go meet people.
No, come say hi. Absolutely. Absolutely. I would love to meet everyone.
Well, thank you very much for your time
today.
Thanks to your gym for letting us come. And everybody be sure to check out www.TinaChandler.com to learn more about Tina and her upcoming projects. And for Nick Del Toro behind the camera, Tina Chandler, I'm Fitadina from MuscularDevelopment.com.